Today, we're diving into the fascinating world of constructive plate boundaries, also known as divergent plate boundaries. We'll break down this process into simple steps so you can easily understand how a new crust is formed and how it shapes our planet. Step 1. What are constructive plate boundaries? Constructive plate boundaries occur where two tectonic plates move apart from each other due to convection currents. This movement creates a gap between the plates. Step 2 is the formation of mid-ocean ridges. As the plates separate, magma rises from the mantle to fill the gap. When this magma reaches the ocean floor, it cools and solidifies, forming a new crust. This process creates underwater mountain ranges known as mid-ocean ridges. The mid-Atlantic ridge is a prime example. Step 3 is creation of rift valleys. On land, when tectonic plates diverge, they create rift valleys. These are large depressions formed by the sinking of the Earth's crust. The East African Rift is a significant example where continental plates are being pulled apart. Step 4 is volcanic activity. The rising magma at constructive boundaries not only forms new crust, but also creates volcanoes. These volcanoes are usually less explosive than those at destructive plate boundaries because the magma at these boundaries are less viscous. Iceland, located on the mid-Atlantic ridge, has many volcanoes. Step 5 is seafloor spreading. As new crust forms at mid-ocean ridges, it slowly moves away from the ridge, causing the seafloor to spread. This process continually adds new material to the ocean floor, pushing older crust further away from the ridge and contributing to the expansion of ocean basins. Next time you think about the Earth's crust, remember the dynamic process of the seafloor spreading and volcanic activity at constructive plate boundaries. These boundaries are vital in continuously shaping and reshaping the Earth's surface.